Today we are going to discuss about chat system. So starting with the general overview, the simplest computer chatting is a method of sending, receiving and storing text messages with a network of users. Every time the client wants to chat, he runs the client application, enters his username, host name where the server application is running, and hits the connect button and starts chatting. So simple is that. Now how it actually works. So coming to network programming, it has 5 steps: network application, protocol stacks, service ports, sockets, client server application. So let's first discuss about network application. Network application exchanges data between physically separated machines. For this to occur, the machines must be connected by a transmission media like a LAN, local area network. This may be in a single building or can be a group of adjacent buildings. Coming to protocol stacks, here we use TCP and IP. TCP/IP is a set of protocols developed to allow computers to share resources across some network. Here we are using LAN, so we will share it with LAN. Now let's see how TCP/IP works. The sender, when we type some message, the sender types the message. The TCP protocol breaks the data into packets. Now the packets travel from router to router over the internet according to IP protocol. Now the TCP protocol reassembles the packets into whole original. Firstly, it has broke the data, and then it reassembles the data as shown. So this is how data transfers over the net. Now let's discuss about service ports. A port is a special location in the computer's memory that exists when two computers are communicating via TCP or IP. Application uses a port number to communicate, and the sending and receiving computers use the same port to exchange data. Now about sockets. For software applications to take advantage of increasingly technology, they require an API which provides a simple and uniform access to this technology. Now in our project we are using Windows, so we would use WinSock data library that has been provided by Windows. Now here is a small code snippet of the sockets client socket. Here we use the struct sock adder underscore in here, and it is its structure. Now here are the some functions in it: the s client socket and send and receive for sending and receiving the messages. Now let's discuss about client server application. Here we have 3 things: client active open, passive open and virtual circuit. The client application creates a socket and actively attempts to connect to the server program, which is active open. Now the passive open is something where server application creates a socket and passively listens for incoming connections. So as it is listening, it is called passive open. Now virtual circuit: when the client wants to connect to the server, it sends a connection request. Now the server is notified that some process is trying to connect with it. By accepting the connection, the server completes the virtual circuit. So this circuit is called virtual circuit. It is generally a communication pathway between two programs. Now the chat server. On the chat server would follow these steps. First of all, it would create a socket. Now it would start listening for incoming connections from clients. Then accept the client connection, send and receive information. Now when we have to terminate the conversation, the socket is closed when this is finished. Okay. Now here you can see the flowchart of how chat server works. Firstly, in the main method, it is always listening to input messages from the server user. Also, it listens to connection requests from clients. And here you can see it is listening for 2 different clients. Here it's client 1 and client 2. Now coming to chat client. In case of this client, these steps are followed. Firstly, a socket is created. Now the specify the address and service port of the server program. The connection is, then it establishes the connection with the server and starts sending and receiving the information. And finally, the socket is closed at the termination of this conversation. Now here you can see its flowchart mapping. Main, it listens to input messages from client user and listens from messages from server. Thanks. And this project was by Aman Gupta, Dapinder, and Ghanshyam. Thanks.